subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon for the latest film interviews, features, and recommendations on the movies that matter. Juhi, thank you so much for allowing us into your home. I'm so happy to see you. But I will say, I've had to move mountains to make this happen. You know, we've been trying to have this conversation for a very long time. I'm going to say here, I feel like this is the first interview that I've had to bribe to be able to get to. I wished you on your birthday in November. Your reply was, "Aise wish karne se kaam nahi chalega, plant 100 trees," which is a very good initiative.
There are no free lunches in life.
That's true. This is of course part of your Kaveri campaign, which is a beautiful campaign. So I planted 100 trees. I donated towards planting 100 trees, which on a journalist's salary, I will tell you, is no chump change. And still it has taken us 5 months to get this time with you, Juhi.
And excuse me, I would like to tell our audience here that for the past 2 weeks, it has been the other way around. I have been the one trying to coordinate this
because I have guilted you into doing this.
Okay.
Juhi, I've known you for like more than 25 years.
I was a child then. Then what else?
You know, one of the most comforting things in life, Juhi, is knowing that the person that you know for very long hasn't changed. And that's really true of you. You know, you're exactly how I've always known you. You're warm. You're funny. You know, there is this great warmth and grace that's always been. There are some things that you care deeply about. There are some things you couldn't care about. I will say one thing. You have never known, you've never learned how to take a compliment. You're always very awkward with compliments. I've noticed this over the years. I also think that, you know, that personality, that warm, funny personality sort of seeped into your roles.
Yeah.
I feel like it really became, it blurred the line between the off-screen Juhi and the on-screen Juhi, and everyone sort of loves that. That is who one loves the most, and that's why you were perfect for the show that we do called Women We Love.
Thank you. Thank you, Rajeev.
Thank you. The chirpy Chawla tag.
No.
I know. It's sort of, that label came quite early on, didn't it?
It did, and I was like, and that time I was like just making a mark in the industry, and I'm like, you know, somebody has things like Shah Khan.
Correct.
And you know, Amir, whatever, they have names which are aspirational, and here I was, Chirpy Chawla. I was like, who did this to me? Who is this? Because then it stuck,
right?
And then instead of being called some charming woman or some beautiful
but
thing, Chirpy's something
a nice
Chirpy
tag.
Chawla, I became like a little bird. It's like, yeah, whatever. Yeah.
But you've always, you know, there's this very famous personality test. They say, which Friends character are you? I feel like you're Phoebe.
And I don't know why everybody, even
Shahrukh. Says that. See?
Shahrukh told me a long time back, and that time I'd not really seen Friends. I was some of the few people left on the planet.
Literally, living under a rock.
Yeah,
right.
Who had not seen it. And he was like, you know, him, Adi, Aditya, Chopra, they say, you remind us of Phoebe.
And but when you did watch it?
I was like, where's the similarity? What were they looking at? But then maybe,
little
I don't
know. A little bit ditzy, very sweet, very, very loving and lovable.
Okay, all right. With those adjectives, I'm fine, I'm happy. We can move on.
But comedy was always your thing, Juhi. Where did that come from? I mean, you know, you're one of the rare, you know, for a long time, and even today, actually, one talks, you know, the easy complaint is that, oh, women aren't funny, which is so unfair, because today you have a lot of actresses that do, but, you know, you did comedy, and you did comedy so well at a time when others didn't. Where did that come from?
That just came along the way. In the beginning, when I started films, honestly, I didn't even know what
your skill set was, right?
What that was. How shall I? I'll have to rewind and go back.
Please.
A little. So I was just starting out. I'd done Saltanat or begun it, and then I got auditioned or selected to do a film down south in Tamil. It was a bilingual, mm-hmm. Tamil and Kannada, mm-hmm. called Premaloka. And Parvaragam in Tamil.
Yeah.
And it was a young unit, first time director, fantastic songs, campus romance, Grease 2 kind of film. And I got Kayamat Se Kayamat Tak. Again, young setup, love story,
correct,
but in Hindi. While Kayamat was still in the writing stages and preparing to take off, down south they're all ready.
Right.
So we started shooting and I feel I really learnt my work down there while working with them. Because we were shooting every day, I was shooting in an alien language, so I was, you know, studying my lines. Luckily I didn't have so many because it was a musical. So lots of dancing, lots of backup dancers, the whole thing, and 9 to 6, 9 to 6. And when the scenes came, you know, I was enacting in a different language.
There.
But I realized I just was happier doing the funnier parts.
Okay.
Of the film.
Correct.
And again in QSQT, when it came to the song,
the lighter moments,
the lighter moments.
Right.
It was just happening.
Sure.
And then slowly I came to be known for it. And really I tried all the other things also, because when you are an actress you want to be able to dance like Madhuri or Immortal, or you know, be seductive like some other one.
Correct.
So I've tried everything, but the easiest thing for me was doing this.
Right.
So really it wasn't.
And you did such lovely films in comedy, you know, you did Bol Radha Bol.
Yeah.
Which I think was the start of it actually. Hame Rahi Pyar Ke came along. All those films with David, you know, Deewana Mastana.
All of them. Yes.
One, two, you know, my favorite comic performance of yours is 1, 2, 4. It's one of those lesser watched films, but you were incredible in it. I remember telling Shah Rukh, and he said she just kind of stole the show in that one.
I've recently watched a scene that I did then in the film. And even I'm amazed at what was happening and what I was doing. But again, there, I loved that role because it had like
so much
both,
to it. Yeah,
there was the funny part,
correct,
at home with the kids, but then there was the diva, and I was like enjoying that as well. But I have to say, backstage, Shah Rukh and the writer. Because Shah Rukh is Delhiite.
Yeah.
And very familiar with the Haryanvi.
Correct.
And the writer had written the lines.
Right.
So literally they used to make me do in our makeup room, they used to make me like, as though I'm a kid at school, I had to do my lines until I got them perfectly right. And then I used to just go to the set and be able to rattle them off and, you know, play with them.
Yeah.
But it was thanks to the two of them.
I told you don't take compliments very well.
No,
you're happy
no,
to sort
no,
of share the, share the praise. You know, what is the trick, Juhi, to doing comedy well and convincingly? I feel that when I see you, you're fearless when it comes to comedy. You know, you're not afraid of looking funny, looking bad. Because in comedy, you contort faces. You're not shy of sort of making a fool of yourself. You seldom do. You actually is that part of it? Just being completely submitting to the moment.
I think the confidence just grew because I told you some of it was just coming from within. And no, I have to give full credit. Again, you may say what you want to say, but I will say what I have to say. That it was so many times, it was the director and the writing.
Sure.
If you take Ishq.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, Induji would actually, the way he said the lines, I had to parrot them. I mean, if I parroted them, I had it.
Right.
It was done. Rajkumar Santoshi ji in Andaz Apna Apna.
Yeah.
The way he would read the scene, the way it was written, I just had to listen to him, watch him, and they were enacting the scene while they were reading. I don't know if they realize it.
Right.
But I just had to try and photocopy it, and everybody thinks it's my thing, but it's actually my director. And Mahesh ji, so when you work with him, I used to fall down laughing because of the way he would explain what is happening. So now act. But his explanation of where
context,
you are,
context,
was so funny. And then a couple of moments actually, I have to even say that Amir gave me. Like there was this time I step out of the room and the kids are sitting, I think, on the dining table and he's sitting
there.
This is
Hame Rai Pyar Ke.
Yeah, Hame Rai Pyar Ke. And he told me, you know, I was wearing a kurta and he told me how to move it so that the sleeves move up this way, that way. Like when you're standing, suddenly the sleeves move side to side. And he had shown me how to do it. So it's all here and there.
You know, there was a moment where you decided, I want to be sexy.
I tried.
But you were very good in, it was Lutere, wasn't it?
I didn't decide that one.
The shirt, because of that, just wearing a shirt on the beach, wasn't it, that whole song?
Yes.
But were you not, was that hard for you to do?
Because at that time it was.
It was? Were you very shy at the moment, at that time? I mean, was it something that you were awkward about?
So this came soon after QSQT. Maybe I'd started Love or something like that. But then this was a radical change in my look and feel and everything. Mm. And it was all Dharmesh Darshan and his imagination. It had to be in a shirt. I was so self-conscious. Because what? I'm in a shirt on a beach.
Correct. Only a shirt, we should
only
say.
A shirt. Only a shirt. Yeah, well, not quite, but
correct.
Quite.
I mean, for what looks on screen.
Yeah. But thank God I had Saroji choreographing. Yeah. So I would... You know,
that was a lovely song, Tu Meri Raani.
Oh, the music of Lutere was fantastic. All the songs were great. Yeah. And this, it just actually, it worked so well. Right. So I have to give again credit to the director. Because had he not thought it like that and insisted, it had to be like this. Yes. And I, like, of course, gave in, okay, theek hai, but you know, it has to look aesthetic.
Yeah.
It can't look tasteless.
Correct.
The moment Saroji was choreographing, I was like, okay. Because she had that, she'd make,
she'd done
work with Sriji and Madhuri, and her work is just, there's finesse.
Yeah.
So then I was comfortable, and then it happened, and it looked, I think, even I have to say that it looked quite nice, really.
But
quite nice.
Were there moments, you know, Juhi, you were this South Bombay girl from Fort Convent School, from Sydenham College.
Yeah.
Were there moments where you were just surprised? I mean, like, that's not what, you know, very few South Bombay girls end up becoming actresses, right? You won, of course, in the middle, we've just omitted that chapter where you won Miss India. In 1984, you won Miss India. You won Best Costume at Miss Universe. Is that all a blur? I mean, how do you remember that?
If we go into this this interview will become one series, where I'll just say, one, you're young and you're silly, and it works just that way. You don't think too much, you jump first, and then, you know, now in retrospect, you're like, what was I thinking, me? Miss India, why would you?
Because
do
you
that?
Were head girl, weren't you? Head girl in
I was
Fort
in
Convent?
School.
Yeah.
And then this
and that's
was in
not
college.
That's not the normal direction, right? That someone who's head girl. I mean, at that time, good girls didn't become actresses, right? You remember what it was?
I don't know. Yeah, in the sense, if one wondered about the film industry. You like even today, you
Correct.
Will hear all kinds of stories about the industry, and then from the outside, it looks quite formidable.
Sure.
Where are you going? And yes, we also as a family, my parents must have been quite spooked and amazed and at the turn of events in my life. Mm. But I feel like somebody out there was leading me, because really this is not my doing. Mm. I can't take credit for any of anything. There's a hand steering you, protecting you at times when you're just about to break sometimes, you're in a vulnerable spot. How you get by, I say thank God, whatever happened.
So Miss India happened apparently because friends were doing it.
Yeah, that was just out of, you know, if they can do it, so I think I'll...
Did you not expect to win?
No, not to win. I thought I will place, somewhere I will place. And then the winning was, I think, it was a smart answer which got me to win.
Okay.
That. You know, the ones that they ask,
been a
and
clever one.
Is that like clever line, if it comes, hits you at that moment and it happens. It was that. But that too, no? How it happens in a flash.
In a moment, yeah.
Otherwise, you sometimes are gobsmacked and you don't know it.
Correct.
So, one thing led to another. It wasn't always smooth, or it wasn't like in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Over days and months, something moved.
Correct.
Something worked, something didn't. Saltanat, my first film,
didn't. Correct.
And the film that was not expected to do anything.
Right.
Because at that time, all the films
the big star films.
Big
and all were these
star.
Newcomers and a new first-time director.
New director, strange music. and ghagra and simple cotton clothes. Right. And at that time it was multi-starers.
That's right.
Big films, big songs, big everything.
Yeah.
And this just came. So look at that.
Do you have memories of making Kamat Se Kamat Tak?
Oh, yes.
What is the one enduring memory? When you think of, when someone brings up that film, what's the memory that instantly sort of jumps to your mind?
No, I have so many. I can't think of one thing, but
you were more experienced by the time you all got to set. You were sort of senior to Amir, weren't you?
You said it. Acha, and to think that at the time of auditioning for QSQT, Amir was teaching me the lines to audition.
Correct.
But meanwhile, like I said, I signed this film, I signed The South, and The South got cracking and I was shooting every day. So over there, after working in Tamil and Kannada, which I didn't know.
Know the language, right?
I came to Ooty. I go to Ooty for shooting of QSQT. And now I come and everybody's speaking in Hindi and talking in Hindi and doing these easy, lovely scenes. I'm like, oh God.
I'm home.
Yeah. I started sailing. And Amir was the one faltering. So yeah, you were right. You are right. I was feeling like a pro. But we had such a great time. Such a wonderful time because we used to rehearse scenes. You know, after shooting, go back. Get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. It's dark outside in Ooty, in the cold. Everybody's getting dressed, doing makeup, running to the location. So I have to tell you, there was this incident during Sultanat, when we went to do the scene in Kashmir. Ek to na Sultanat was huge star cast.
Correct.
I was very, very scared about shooting and I wouldn't utter a word during shooting. I didn't know what to talk to even Karan about, because
right.
For me he was Shashi Kapoorji's son.
Son, correct.
And such a good looking person.
Correct.
And then we're doing this song sequence in Kashmir. Nazar ne nazar se kya kaha. And we're not getting the dance steps right. Going wrong, take after take after take. And then Kamal Masterji's assistant, she came and she gave me a firing. And at that time, I kind of quietened down, whatever, managed the shots. And at the end of the shooting, I was like, I'm not going to work anymore. I don't want to do this. And I started bawling, you know. But that like kind of scarred me because I became very scared of choreographers.
Right.
Then I go to the South and I do all this and Chinni Masterji and Rekha Ji and this lovely dancers and rehearsals and this, that and the other. Then I come to, which was a great experience.
Sure.
There it was fantastic.
Mm.
Then I come to Hindi and now I'm scared again because now there's another choreographer and he's going to, I hope I don't get a firing. Suresh Masterji, so lovely. In the song sequence, before the sequence has started, we've already shot the scene.
Uh-huh.
I have two plats, but he had imagined that, you know, she's
open hair
because lighting is better like that.
Correct.
Now, how do you do this? Suresh Master is like, oh, it's very easy to do nothing. Juhi, first of all, he told me, what you feel like doing, you do. I'm like, really? I can do what I feel like. So this angrai lena that
gazab
ka hai din and all. And then I'd open one ribbon,
yes.
One plait opens up in the next line, the other one, and then I have open hair. So easy, he made everything so
easy, right,
effortless.
Right.
And I was like, thank God. So really shooting QSQT was like working with a college, on a college play, or like, you know, with people you're not scared of, just having a great time.
You've made more than 100 films, Juhi, over 34 years. You made.
I have.
You have.
I don't know if it went over 100. It did.
I think it did. You know, if you count
wow.
the little cameos, the guest appearances, It's more than 100 films. Do
Ooh.
You feel? You know, there was a moment. I think it was the year 93 was very big because there was Hum Hai Rahi Pyar Ke that year.
Ah.
I think there was Dar that year. Luteria also came out that year. You won the Filmfare Award for Dar, I think, that year.
There maybe came the next. I don't know. I can't remember.
You know,
but
there was that
spate.
Period. Yeah, there was a spate of hits. It was that moment where, you know, where Juhi was number one. Do you feel though, Juhi, over the years, do you feel that you got your due as an actress?
But that's my own doing, huh?
Yes. Now, we're coming to that.
Before you ask me, I'll tell you. I think, ek to I became pig-headed. I suddenly thought the industry will stop if I don't work. I got some amazing chances to work in films, but my ego came in the way. And I didn't do some films that I could have done, which may have been harder work.
Right.
And more competitive. And I just didn't do them. I just didn't. I wanted the easy stuff. I wanted the stuff I was comfortable with. I wanted to work with people I was comfortable with. And I didn't break barriers and, you know, do something completely.
Correct. Mrityudand.
Mrityudand. I didn't do Dil to Pagal Hai. I didn't do Raja Hindustani. I made stars out of everybody else.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, you know, it made Karishma's career. Those two films,
absolutely.
Dil to Pagal Hai and
absolutely. She said, I'm
thank
behind.
You. And she said thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. So I am responsible for her stardom.
Do you look back with regret?
Regret? I think it was a lesson in my life. Like, you always, when you make mistakes, you learn.
Yeah.
So I've realized that, you know, yeah, the moment you start flying in your head and you think you're the cat's whiskers, you start making mistakes.
While you were still very busy as an actress, you got married to Jai.
Yeah.
I think it was 95?
Abhi zyada mat poocho. We are on camera.
You complete 25 years. Ah, wo to sab chup chup ke kiya. Un dino mein karte the.
Sab karte the.
Why, I mean, was the, why did it need to be like that? I mean, quietly. Like the friends knew.
Yeah, why did it have to be like that? That time, well, one, you didn't have the internet and you didn't have cameras on every phone.
Right.
So you could do it that way. Also, I was just about established and just doing well. And that's the time, you know, Jai was like serenading me.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was afraid of losing my career just when I'd kind of got there.
Yeah.
So I wanted to carry on. And this seemed the midway.
Right.
Okay, you know, let's keep it quiet. And it's okay, you carry on working. Then the next year, that year, my mom passed away as well. So I had another tragedy. And that was a very difficult time for me as well. Because I felt I was going to lose everything I had, you know, everything I loved, my work or my mom. I just lost it all. Then somehow stayed on. And here we are.
You know, your mom passed away while you were shooting, while you were working. Because on set. That must have been
horrific. Horrific, let's not talk about it because
You said Jai was your anchor at the time. You said that you really leaned on him at the time, and he'd faced personal tragedy of his own before that.
Him, and I'd also say Shahrukh, because Shahrukh was with me when we were there, and he was there, and I remember just being totally. How do I say? Devastated. And to try and forget about it, I would, you know, just jump into work so that. And Shahrukh would try and make us all laugh like he always does. I mean, he does it to everybody. And then he would just make sure that, you know, I was around and they'd keep it all happy and stuff. And that's how I got by. So, yeah.
How did Jai and you, I mean, you know, where did you all, sort of, how did you all connect? I mean, you said on Coffee with Karan, you said he wooed you for about a year with flowers and chocolates and the like. How did you meet?
You really want to know?
Yeah, of course, everyone
wants
to know.
Who's interested?
Everyone wants to know.
Who's interested?
Everybody's interested.
Are you crazy? This is like history.
We live in gossip times. Everyone wants to poke their nose into other people's lives.
This is like all that.
He wasn't from your world. He was from business. Where, you know?
Maybe we should ask him.
Yeah, that's true. What did he do right?
So we'd met earlier when I was even younger and I had not yet started out in the industry. But that was briefly and with friends, and he had another set of friends, but somewhere South Mumbai is
correct.
It's still small,
it's
you
small,
know,
yeah,
where
yeah, yeah.
and what. But then I lost touch because I started working, and then I was in Andheri and doing my thing, and it was only at a dinner, friend's dinner, which was again in town, and that's when I saw him. And then we got talking again, and from then on, everywhere I turned, he turned up. Everywhere I looked, he was with flowers and notes and you know, gifts, and every day. And on my birthday, I remember, there was a truckload of red roses. I'm like, a truckload? What do you do with a truckload of, what can you do with a truckload of flowers? But there it was. So yeah, he really did all he could. And then eventually, after a year or something, then he proposed, and I was like, okay. Yeah.
This year, it's 25 years.
No, next year.
Next year. Mm-hmm. 25 years to your marriage. What do you think, you know, what makes this, I mean, you'll see the, you know, you'll have been through the good times. Do you also think it is the fact that you'll have, that, you know, that he saw you through tragedy, the fact that he has been through, do you think that that is a big part of it? That is, you know, one connects on the hard parts as well.
So when a door closes, a window opens. And truly in my case, yes, it was Jai. It was his parents, his mom especially. Mm. There were times when I was like really, really down and out. And she always said to me, you're like my daughter. Don't think of yourself as a daughter-in-law. Think of, you are my daughter. Do what makes you happy. And she allowed me to go out and do work, you know, be doing films, if that's what made me happy. Because I only felt like, okay, this is what I knew. I just about got my bearings in this, and then everything was falling apart. So she really supported me. And yeah, time and again, I think it's God's blessings that I have a family who's just been there for me while mine one by one went away.
You know, speaking of that, we have to talk about Bobby, your brother. It's actually today, it's 6 years to his passing.
How do you know this?
I do my research.
You really do some research. You know, I forgot today, and well, I got reminded like by something, and now you're the second person telling me this. Yeah.
Was that really hard? And you know, the fact that he was in a coma for what, 5 years?
4 years in the hospital, not once home. And a lot of it was in the ICU. And yeah.
Can anything prepare one for that? You were very close growing up. He used to fight, actually.
Yeah, because he was so much older. He was older. So in that sense, we were not close that way. But of course, he was my only brother. And after my parents passed away, you think your brother's going to be there forever.
Correct.
You're going to grow old together. Mm. And then, what happened to him was something I had never even heard of or thought can ever happen to anybody close to me.
Was it?
So when you say, why are you humble, why are you simple, I'm like, you know, oh, I've seen the best and then I've seen the worst.
What are the lessons, Juhi? What does one take away from these things? From pretty much, like you rightly said, you know, losing your entire family, you know, your sort of birth family, your blood relatives. Mm. How does that shape a person? Does everything else seem trivial in comparison? You know, how films do, and you know, kid getting a bad report card 1 year. KKR not doing well one season.
One season for all
a
of
good
them.
Good thing for you. I don't know jack about cricket, so. So we'll save you those questions.
Oof, those were also very trying times. Yeah, the first initial years when we used to come at the bottom of the list.
Correct.
And my children at home would bawl and cry and say, what is this team you have? And they go to the Ambani school.
Correct.
So it wasn't easy for them.
Mumbai Indians over there.
So it was, you know, now you can laugh at it. But at that time, I was like, I'm so sorry, but I can't do anything about it. Yeah.
But when, you know, when Jai and Shah Rukh and you decided to invest in that, I mean, was cricket something you knew or cared about?
Well, boys do, and right. It was just exciting because all my life I've only heard that, you know, two amazing things we have in India.
Correct.
Which
films and cricket.
You know, which take people by with their hearts.
True.
Films and cricket. And here we were getting to be part of a league which was going to happen, and but at that time we didn't know that it would be a runaway success. Mm. We were just investing in something exciting. It's starting up, and Shah Rukh immediately started the marketing ideas and what shall we call it and how should the logo be and what the colors should be and how's the uniform. He started already.
Right.
But yes, it took them a while to really get a good team together, and success took a little while coming.
You know, we have to talk about Shah Rukh and the role that, you know, the role that he's played in your life. I mean, you were actually the first star that he worked with. Weren't you, again, seniors? You were senior to all these guys, right?
Yeah, I had started.
Yeah.
So I must have been 3 years into the industry, and then he came along. But he, you know my famous story.
They told you he looks like Aamir Khan. And you said something really quite mean.
What do you mean? I just told you the truth.
say it again for those that
haven't. See? Say it again.
They told you, we're casting, this is Raju Banga, gentlemen. Yes. We're casting this new boy. His name is Shah Rukh Khan. He's from Delhi and he looks a little bit like Aamir. And now repeat
and
what you
time,
said at that time.
He was a big star on television, but I had not watched his serial. I had no idea who
right.
it was. And yeah, he looks like Aamir Khan. So I'm thinking, Aamir Khan, good looking, fair, light eyes.
What did you call him?
I was like, from which angle is this Aamir Khan? Because there he was, thin, scrawny, brown, hair like this, like a cap, and white shirt and pants, and I was like, and a nice fat nose, and I'm like, really, what is this? No, it was, but then it was such a joy working with him. He was so much fun from the word go. He was never new.
Yeah.
Like he was.
Correct.
Because.
Never felt like a, yeah, yeah.
Because he had his theater and he had worked with, I think, in circus.
That's
and he'd
right.
worked in 4G.
4G, correct.
So he'd do rehearsals and add 20 things to the scene which you have not
thought of. Right.
And it was so much fun, happy energy, and I was like, okay, this is great. And then, yes, of course, got to know him over the years.
We went on to do such lovely films together. You know, Raju, of course.
Yeah.
Yes, Boss. You all launched a production company together, Dreams Unlimited.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You all made a few films under that banner, starting with Phir Bhi Dil Hai Hindustani. You know, when one has known someone for really long, then, of course, the company folded up. Does every such relationship have ups and downs?
Of course. I think.
Because you all have had those.
Yeah,
you've spoken about a time when there was a sort of lack of communication.
Yeah. So I guess it, because after we worked in that, then we made Ashoka.
Yeah.
That won a lot of critical acclaim when at the box office again was not all that successful. Then they started Chante Chalte. So I was helping behind the scenes, but then I was expecting. So then I had to go away. I was in London for a lot of the time. They made the film. I think after that, And I'm not sure why. Then Azizji, yes. Azizji lost his wife, so he was heartbroken. Then I'm not exactly sure why, but then we didn't really make more films in Dreams. Yeah, because we needed Azizji to come up with another script, and then at that moment he wasn't.
How did that change the personal relationship? If one isn't necessarily, you know, working together, that will.
And I think at that time again, my life, my work, my family was, you know, becoming, was growing.
Right.
It was growing in another direction. I was moving in another direction. I couldn't help it. And so that's when I wasn't, earlier you're on the sets with your co-star.
Correct.
Now you're behind the scenes. Now you're even further away because you're busy.
Yeah.
At that time, my nature of work changed. Yeah. I was suddenly doing films like Teen Deewaare and
Correct.
My Brother Nikhil and Jhankar Beats, which whenever anybody heard the title, they were like, is that a video?
Correct. Some remix video.
Remix video. So I'd be, no, it's a movie. And what's the star cast? And I would take the names and everybody'd look at me like, yeah, okay. So,
Correct.
But,
you know, but you've
those
actually
were
spoken,
wonderful films.
You've actually spoken, Juhi, about that time when you sort of began to transition, as all actresses do, from leading lady to supporting roles to character roles. And you've said that it initially it took some getting used to. It hurts the ego a little bit.
Yes, it was very different. Later on, I realized, thank God, it's very refreshing.
Yeah.
Because. But yes, like you said, no, here, just before that, Ishq and Phir Bhi Dil Hai Hindustan, this and that and the other, budgets running into crores and crores and dancers all dressed up behind you and during a song sequence.
Correct.
You're in some Neeta Lulla outfit and doing the jig. And then you're doing a film which is like My Brother Nikhil, which is lovely actors, but it's very real.
Yeah.
Your clothes are just very, very simple.
Yeah.
There are no dancers.
Right. Lucky to have a makeup van if you do.
No makeup van.
Right.
You had rooms and things. But, oh, it was such a wonderful experience.
Actually, you've done your best work after, Juhi. You've done some of your best work after.
No.
Deewaare. No, it is true. You know, I think also at the time that you were a leading lady, you know, there wasn't a lot of stuff, I mean, and you were turning down all the good stuff. So you kind of, you know, there wasn't a lot of range for a leading lady, was there? I mean, you really just, you know, one just danced and showed up for the songs. But it's actually, you know, look at what you did in Luck by Chance.
I loved it. Yeah.
How
that
incredible.
Was still mainstream though.
That is true. But it was after you had, after you had stopped doing the leading roles.
Yes. Then I was just, the leading
Teen Deewaare. I mean, this is stuff, I am. Again, these were some great roles.
Yeah. I mean, I want to say this about, say, Teen Deewaare when I went there. So Nagesh, so this role is of a housewife, Hyderabad, small house, journalist or something she is.
Yeah.
And they told me, okay, now no makeup, no hair, no this, no that. So I'm like, ek toh, I'm not used to this only. I have to have makeup on. So I would do my own makeup, whatever little, just touch up and all, and my hairdresser would get me ready. 20 minutes flat we used to be ready for those kind of scenes. But I'd cheat and start putting a little bit lipstick, you know, because I can't, I feel very bare. I'd go in front of the camera and it's sync sound. The sync sound at that time was also new.
New, correct.
So I'll stand in front of the camera ready for the scene and all. First the sound person, madam, please don't move your hands because the bangles, they jingle, so we can't, I'm sorry. Then from behind the camera, Nagesh look up. Juhi, lipstick can be seen, take it off. then something where we start the scene, Juhi, don't act. Just say the lines. Just say them. Don't act. I'm used to acting. I don't know what it means not to act. So I'm like, and then they, you know, the film released, it got some critical acclaim or something.
Yeah,
and
yeah, it was very popular, yeah.
Something, and then got the screen award for it. And I was like, you know, thank you. You didn't let me act.
Right.
You didn't let me put on any makeup. You told me not to move. And still you gave me the best actress.
Right.
That is what happened to me. But this was not by design. It was just the way you know, my life moved
correct
in that
also
direction.
Was that time, right? You were sort of transitioning at that time when Hindi cinema was changing. I mean, look at your performance in I Am. It was wonderful. And again, not the kind of role that one immediately associates Juhi Chawla with, you know?
I was very happy with that because I was working with Manisha.
That's right.
I said, throughout our career, we've never got a chance or anything. She was always in another film. I was in another film. Somewhere you're competing with each other. But here you were just comfortably through with all that and playing friends and very nice and shooting in Kashmir.
Correct.
After many, many years of nobody going there.
True.
So,
you also got a chance to work with another colleague of yours in Gulab Gang. You worked with
Madhuri. Oh, boy.
Because for the longest time, you all were sort of pitted against each other.
Yeah.
You all had opportunities to work together, which you've admitted you turned down because you didn't want to. You thought there would be unnecessary comparisons.
Yeah. I was not Dil ready for hai. It. Yes. And I didn't want. After that, I was like, I can't play second heroine too.
So what was it like working in Gulab Gang?
Very bad. This is what I meant. Right. I lost my marbles.
Well, you were not the only one. Lots of people thought like that, right? Lots of actresses after you said no to that.
Yeah, strangely, actually, I think Yashji for a long while had to, and he came back to me 2-3 times to say, you know, the offer came back to me. And look at me, I was stupid. It's like just like Dar, if you think about it. So many actors turn the role down
correct.
Because they didn't want to do it. And then Shah Rukh does it and becomes a star.
Star, right.
And then here I was saying no to this. And then Karisma does it and...
Yeah. National award she got for
National
that.
National award. So, I guess it's written.
What was working with Madhuri like?
Wonderful.
Were you sort of, by that time, had the competitive spirit, if you like? Sort of that competitive energy gone or was that still there?
So what was, first of all, when I heard that role right here in my house as we sit. So we are sitting in the other room when they narrated this role to me from the writing team. There's somebody else whom we've all known.
Uh-huh.
He was the one who called me up, said, you know, I've got a kick-ass role for you to do. So I was like, okay, come, you know,
correct.
Let me hear it. I'm thinking something is going to happen. Then they start narrating Gulab Gang. I'm playing the strange villain.
Yeah.
Why am I doing this? Who will believe me if I do this? So I told them, no, I can't do this. As it is, the role in length is not big.
That's right.
The hero is out and out hero.
Correct.
The villain gets a beating in the end. Why would I be doing this? I didn't understand it only.
Right.
And no justification for why,
she's like that. Which actually made it most interesting.
Most interesting. So I said, no, and nobody will believe me, and how will I act? I don't know how to do this.
Right. Though you had done, briefly, Arjun Pandit, you had done.
Arjun Pandit. But there again, you're still playing the heroine.
Right.
It's twisted.
It was in that, it's a twist, correct.
And then you realize
and there's justification for it, and there's revenge. And
here, there's nothing. I sent them packing. I was like, nah, nothing. I'll let you know. I'll call you. Don't call me. Then they went and they rewrote the whole thing. And justified it and made Sumitra Devi that she looks after her aged father-in-law. He was the person before.
Right.
Like, and then the husband, and now the husband is no more, and now she has to take on a mantle.
Right.
And then she has to do what she has to do.
Correct.
Just to stay in power. But it just lost the zing.
Mm.
So I was like, no. If at all it has to be done, you're right. You have to do it the way you wrote it earlier. Then it took me 2-3 months of sleeping over it, and then I said, okay, I'll do it.
Madhuri already attached?
Madhuri was attached from the beginning. Also, I told them, you know, at this moment, you need me more than I need
That's
you.
That's true. It was a great coup. It was the coup. It was that the casting was the film.
Yeah. I said, with anybody else,
it
doesn't have the same flavor.
Right.
So, this is it. So I understand that. And then in my head, I realized that since I'm playing the villain and she's playing the hero, there's no comparison. If you're both playing heroes,
right,
then you say this hero is better than that hero.
Correct.
But a villain is a villain.
Yeah.
You can't compare a hero to a villain.
Correct.
And then the way Somik was reading the lines, By now he had read them to me at least 3-4 times. I said, then I just have to copy the way he does it. And what I did in the film was a photocopy of Soumik Sen, and it worked.
You know, I want to talk about what you said about motherhood. You said that motherhood completely changed you, Juhi.
Yeah.
It's hilarious because you did films like Hame Rahi Pyar Ke Tha, and apparently you weren't particularly fond of children at the time. You said that they sometimes got on your nerves and you would wish they would put them in a different room.
Yes, I own my statement.
So that maternal instinct just came when it came, did it?
When it came, yes, then it was a different story where I became protective of every child I saw.
Correct.
But until then, I thought children were pests. I didn't know why they were on this planet. So, but yeah, so I'd treat them just like, you know, younger little brothers and sisters who annoying little things. And I worked with them in like Hame Rahi Pyar Ke or One Two Ka Four.
Yeah.
I had them all over
yeah,
me.
Yeah.
But I would run away the moment my scene was done. I was not sitting with those children. Yes, and no, then when you see your own child, and then everything changes.
They're now grown up, and
yeah.
and Janvi is 19.
Yeah.
She's at Columbia.
Yes.
Arjun is in class 10.
Yeah.
They're both away from home. They've sort of flown the nest, as they say.
Yeah.
Do you feel, does that implore you to work more then? That, you know, the kids are at that age where they don't need their parents now, no?
Not that they don't need you.
Uh-huh.
When they need things,
they are the first ones
to call.
Of course.
But yes, they're away, and I have certain spells in my life where they're not around, and I have the time to myself, and I do interviews like this.
Thank
and
you. I have to say thank you to them.
Yeah, see, credit goes actually somewhere else. And I, of late, I've somehow been getting involved in a lot of matters. Apart from films.
Correct.
Which I find give me immense. Now I understand when people used to say, now you feel an inner joy and peace when it's selfless work. Strangely, I worked for, you know, awareness about radiation.
That's right.
Then plastic came into my life and I was like, no, I have to use myself to really put the word out there as much as I can.
Sure.
Then it became environment and trees, and also a gurukul that we have. Our family has a trust and it runs a gurukul in Porbandar.
Mm.
There's about 2,000 girls studying there. It's been a gurukul which has been there for about 80 years, 80 odd years. So now it's fabulous. It's a 90-acre campus. It's beautiful buildings, but now they need to be, you know, you need to bring the tradition is there,
right.
But we just need to modernize it a bit, keeping the tradition alive because the teachings there are fabulous.
Right.
So working on that. So in all these, and apart from some nice assignments that, you know, come my way, I
correct.
Do them. My days are great.
I want to ask you, in the past few years, you know, the Me Too movement has gathered a lot of momentum. We've seen how Bollywood has come under the scanner, and how the film industry, you know, things that we always sort of knew but not entirely, and had heard about, and now people are being called out and being named.
Hmm.
You know, as someone who's worked for all these years, how do you look at what's happened in the last few years, and do you feel like there will be concrete change? It will lead to.
So one, I want to defend my industry.
Yeah.
Because I feel you meet good, bad, ugly
in
everywhere.
Every business, of course.
Everywhere. But because we are in
this
the limelight.
Correct.
And this is what makes headlines.
Yeah.
And this is what makes interesting reading. This
correct.
Is what gets splashed.
The most,
more.
Yeah, visibility, right.
What's nice about this is that now people will think twice before indulging in any of
right.
this. So that's the nice thing. I mean, nobody's going to forget this quickly. And with the amount of media, you know, there's just so much
social
internet,
media.
Social
yeah.
media and everything. Nothing really remains, you know, hidden for too long.
True.
And it just gets exposed and then it becomes viral and then everybody knows about it.
Correct.
So people will be more cautious, which is good. So it makes it a level field playing ground kind of thing.
Did you face any uncomfortable situations?
I did. I mean, difficult in the sense, like I didn't know what to say at that moment
right.
when somebody said something to me which may have meant something else, and I would just laugh and like just kind of pretend like I didn't understand and
correct.
Move away. So there have been moments where I've like said, oh my God, what
was
is
that,
this?
Was that what I think it was? Right.
Yeah, well, I want to look like I don't know what he said.
Mm-hmm.
And that was half of me, why I was giggling at times.
Correct.
Because I was like, okay, I'd rather you think I'm dumb and just let me come and go.
Yeah. How do you think women need to empower themselves and how do you think real change will come?
It's difficult for me to say sure. what can change it completely. Can there be a utopian world?
Correct.
I don't know if we'll ever reach that.
Right.
But what I feel is nice is like today in the industry, I mean, when I came in and before me also,
yeah.
for the longest time, there were four women on the sets.
True.
Me, my mom or aunt, if they came along.
Correct.
My hairdresser. My stylist.
Yeah.
These four or five people, that was it.
True.
The rest were all men. Now you go to any set, 40-50% are girls, young girls. I mean, my entire team, if you look here, are all girls.
Right.
I look around me, I'm like, my manager, my PR people, my stylist, my makeup person, my hairdresser, all girls.
Right.
I have an all-girl team since when?
Correct.
So.
And that will lead to change, won't it?
It's already has an, because the safety in numbers.
Yeah.
You're not the only one who has
correct.
To feel anything. If you want to get out of a situation or anything
yeah,
happens,
you know who to go to. You know,
there are people around.
You know, you were asked in an interview how you managed to stay so content and you said, be grateful. It's not the happy people who are grateful, but the grateful people who are happy.
Oh.
Very wise words.
That was one of my moments.
But you clearly live by that, don't you?
I do. And again, it's my experiences in life which have taught me that there is so much that that is going right. And I'm human. I still do. There are days when I wonder, you know, have I gotten left behind or, you know, am I not doing enough work or am I not out there enough? But I'm like, you know what? I'm happy.
Yeah.
It's okay. When things are to come to you, they will come to you. What's meant for you will happen. Because when I look back too, I see that it wasn't me who went out and got a Kayamat se Kayamat tak.
Yeah.
It wasn't me who went out and got a Sultanat. But
correct.
Because the Sultanat flopped and a Kayamat did well, I am where I am.
Yeah.
None of it was my doing.
Right.
It came.
Right.
Things will come.
So you haven't changed at all since I've known you.
You mean there's no improvement?
No. What I mean is that you're still as hopeful and optimistic. You know, I used to come away from meeting you with a big smile. That smile is very contagious, you know. I used to feel like, you know, just sort of positively motivated. And I feel like that hasn't changed. Thank you. Please continue to stay this way. You really are a woman we love. I think that you know how to bring joy in people's lives through your work, of course, because I think you've made us laugh so much. And I don't think we give enough credit to those that make us laugh. It seems so trivial, but it's really to have that gift to be able to make someone laugh and to improve someone's life, even if it is for a few minutes in a day. That's so rare. Thank you for that. And I think I speak for all of your fans.
Thank you.
And please don't stop working. You can do the, I will continue to plant trees for you every other year.
I hope we meet again and chat about it again. Yes.
Thank you.
Continue the good work.
We'll continue. We'll follow in your footsteps. Make sure you show us the way.
Yeah.
But thank you so much, Juhi. And really looking forward to lots more. You have a lot to give still. I hope you continue making the movies, especially when you find the parts that really excite you. I hope you continue.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Juhi. Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.